What's up, guys? Welcome back to Homes on Wheels. Heath and I today are at the home place in Warrior, Alabama. We're filming a brand new home that literally they are setting up as we speak. There's three guys working on this thing, crawling all over it on ladders, but somehow we convinced them to let us film. And I'm glad because this is one that actually took my breath away when we walked in.
Nobody's filmed this yet.
Yeah, nobody's filmed it to our knowledge. So let's go ahead and head in here and take a look around. There again, this doesn't feel like a mobile home. If you look around the side, there's jut ins, jut outs, different angles, built-in porches, the whole nine yards. Absolutely stunning house.
Wow. And they've already started staging it. They haven't finished, but wow. You got this foyer entryway here, and
that's,
I'm just gonna
awesome.
Turn, and they've got a coat closet right here by the door. Where do you expect a coat closet to be? They don't have the closet or the rack up yet for it. But
they said they heard us pitching so many Amazon racks that they were just gonna stop putting them.
He's kidding. Oh man, so this is a nice take on open and not open, because it kind of splits up with that foyer. But then the kitchen and the living room area is together.
Well, I feel like I'm at home.
It's easy to do.
I mean,
in your dreams, man.
I know, right? I don't know. Maybe one day we'll strike it rich, right?
Actually, this home is not a bad price, and we'll tell you more about that at the end of the video.
I think I could swing it.
And you could swing
with
this.
With interest rates the way they are, you know, once upon a time, the interest rates for a house was much lower than for a mobile or a modular home.
Yeah.
Right now, they're within like a fraction of a point of each other.
Yeah, that's what they were telling us a while ago, and this is as of June 2023. So.
Yeah, and also, there's no PMI on these homes.
I didn't know that.
Yeah, there's no PMI whenever you finance a mobile home. So that saves you a chunk of change right there. I think the PMI on our house is like over $100 a month.
Wow.
Yeah, so that's a good savings in itself.
That is a good savings. Can we get out there on the porch?
We can look real quick while they're not working on it.
Okay.
So usually we wouldn't just jump out here like we are, but we're trying to be mindful of everybody working on this home.
Since and
so get, nice.
While getting this video to you, probably before you've seen it before.
So right here is the back porch, if you will. When we walked up a while ago, that was completely across the way from us. This is a good size porch. There's no fireplace or anything like that on this one, so there's not a whole lot to worry about other than you come out here and set up a porch swing and a couple of gliders and you're ready to rock and roll.
And feel that breeze already blowing through, man.
It feels good.
Wow.
So it's nothing more frustrating to me than to have a home and not have a plug on the exterior of the home. So as you can see, they do have some exterior plugs on this home. That's just handy if you, I mean, there's a lot of people nowadays that don't use necessarily a, you know, a weed eater with an extension cord. They've now got batteries that will do that. But there's certain things like vacuuming your car out. You know, you got to have a plug on the exterior home to get to it unless you want to run all kinds of crazy cables.
Or like me, I've got a electric pellet smoker.
Well, there you go. That'd be a
I use a Rectech pellet smoker, and it's amazing. They plug in right there. Oh. I'll put a link to what I use down in the description.
So we kind of breezed through this living room trying to catch that outside before they went back to work, and you heard a bunch of hammering. But this is a beautiful fireplace. It is wood burning. As you can see, it's got shiplap up above it. You do have that natural rough sawn looking,
Wood.
Couldn't get it out. Man, I guess we shouldn't have drank that beer on lunch. I don't know. I'm just kidding, guys.
Kidding.
No, but this right here, though, to me, that natural wood look is what I really enjoy. I love the farmhouse style, and that could be because my wife's influenced me so much. I don't know. But if you turn around out of this living room and look over here, you're just greeted by this really warm, wide open and spacious kitchen. Instead of having white cabinets, you have more of an oak colored, like a lightish stain on it. I mean, it's not super dark, but it's not as bright white as those beige or those typical white cabinets that you see. And they're doing something in these homes there again that's different than a lot of people. They're using two different kinds of countertops. So over here, this looks like barn wood, which is really nice. It kind of continues that farm theme from the living room. Over here, to me, this almost looks like petrified wood, doesn't it?
It really does, yeah.
It kind of looks like a petrified wood countertop. You do have a nice tile backsplash back here. There again, you've got plugs all along this wall. If you see the stickers on there, they are GFCI rated, so you don't have to worry about splashing water or something like that up in there and getting electrocuted. Just a nice safety feature. This home features beautiful Frigidaire stainless steel appliances, nice cabinets, like in all of the Deer Valley homes, soft close. Look how deep these are. Nice
oh,
and
yeah.
deep. That That's tall. Look at that. You almost need a step ladder to get up there. If you look up in here too, you can see the beam continues all the way across to the living room and the ceiling. They're utilizing the hang down lights just to kind of give it an accent, but your main lights are coming from all the Ken lights throughout the home.
And we've got right over here, we've also got a really nice pantry that caught my eye. I want to show you guys that. I love good sized pantries, and that's a decent sized pantry right there too, with space in the floor so that you can stack drinks or whatnot in there as well.
Well, in the island is the sink, and it's time for the heat test. It works.
It works. It passed.
It works. It is a single basin stainless steel sink. The cabinets do change colors on the island. So if you look over here and then look over here, you see it's much darker. However, I like that. I like having a mix up in the style. These are very, very large cabinets, by the way. I mean, there's a lot of room under there. You can put anything you wanted to. And you can see that the shelves are adjustable. You can actually move them up and down, so you don't have to get under there and get crazy with it. If you don't like where it's placed, it's very easy to change. You do have your dishwasher on this side. It is directly across from the stove, so that's kind of a big deal for a lot of folks, and just the ease of things. So I guess we're gonna go down that really long hallway over here.
Wow, that is a long hall.
And let's see, there's so many doors, it's a eeny, meeny, miny, moe.
Just take the first one.
I'm gonna take the first
one. Take the first one.
You got a half bath right here.
Half bath, yep.
Which is great. A half bath is very functional for people when you have them over to your house. Say you wanted to clean the bathroom really quick, you got unexpected guests, you don't want to have to worry about cleaning the entire shower and everything.
Right.
You only got to worry about the toilet and the sink. And then as you pass that half bath and you make a right, you step back into a laundry room. And it goes around the bend.
Way around the bend.
This is deep in here. You got your hot water heater based right here on the left side of where your washer and dryer would be. There again, it's a nice big hot water heater.
And it's close to the kitchen, which would be on the other wall.
Yes.
So it's not like you're going to lose a lot of heat either. So.
Yeah, and honestly, there's enough room in here. I think you could probably put right here in the corner a stand-up freezer.
I think, yeah, or one of the smaller chest freezers,
right
too.
Still have a room to open.
Absolutely, yeah.
Worth noting, heat and air conditioner is in the floor of this home. You do have a wire rack above that that could be replaced with a wooden rack. You have your electrical panel right next to the rear door. So here's your rear door and your electrical panel. And we'll make our way on around. This is one of those homes that's so big, if we don't watch it, we'll have y'all on here for 30 minutes, and we're trying not to spend too terribly much time, but we want to be thorough. We want y'all to know what's in every one of these doors.
Heating and air.
Heat and air return.
And it's got the...
They put sheetrock on the backside.
Yep.
There again, it's all about soundproof. You know, they want these things to be as quiet as a stick-built house. And honestly...
Probably quieter. I hadn't seen stick-built houses do that.
Okay, I'll
But it's a good idea. I'm going to do it at ours now.
I'm going to throw a builder under the bus. Are you ready?
Yeah.
D.R. Horton Homes are down here in the South. They're huge between the beach and Alabama and everywhere. And they build all these neighborhoods that are like cookie cutter neighborhoods.
Yeah.
And me and my dad, we do a lot of construction work. So in those D.R. Horton homes, they're not built nowhere near as good as these are.
Really?
Nowhere near. And people are paying way out the butt for those.
In your opinion?
In my opinion. There again, D.R. Horton, you can get mad if you want. I'm just speaking the truth. They don't do mobile homes, so they can't get mad at us.
Yeah.
This is a beautiful home, though. This is the nice-sized guest bathroom or bedroom right here. There again, big windowsills. If you got cats, they'll love them. I love the fact that the windows aren't just small or up this high. I like that they go all the way within about a foot of the floor.
Yeah.
Just lets that much more natural light in.
And guys, just a quick reminder, we don't work for this, any of these homes tours that you see. The lots we go to. The dealers, we don't work for any of them. We don't take, if you buy one, we don't make any money.
Yeah, we're not getting commission off this.
We don't get commission off any of this. We just do the tours because they like for you guys to see the homes, and we like to film them. Works out.
Well, and if you do want to support me and Heath and our endeavors doing this, the best thing you can do for us is to drop a comment, a like, and a subscription.
And a share.
Yeah,
share helps too.
Share it, share away.
Share it to your friends. If you know they're looking for a home, you like what you see.
Or if you pick one out that you like and you want to ask somebody's opinion, this is a good way. Instead of dragging them all the way to the lot, you can say, hey, let me send you this video link and they can check it out.
We have a lot of husbands and wives that actually send their their significant other a link to our video to decide whether or not before they make the drive somewhere.
Now, this is a big guest bedroom. This is big enough you could put a king-size bed in here. It's got two big windows in it, nice walk-in closet.
Yep.
It does go to carpet in here. Some folks like that, some don't. Let us know in the comments below if you like carpet or if you like hardwood in the bedroom. We like asking that just to get a feel for what everybody does enjoy. I personally do like the carpet in the bedrooms unless it's for a kid.
Yeah, I prefer the hardwood, but I've gotten used to the slick floors.
Yeah, well, and that's the other
It's following what you like, though.
Well,
There's nothing wrong with either one.
But do you like sweeping or do you like vacuuming?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, but, you know, you ask me that in the winter, I say I wish I had carpet.
Right. Well, here is another full bathroom right here. And this, there again, instead of just being a typical galley style where it's straight in, straight out, it's got a little bit of width to it.
Yeah.
It does have a single-piece shower unit. Beautiful cabinet in there with a sink in it. And it is much brighter when all the light bulbs are in. But there's
got a little closet in there for your towels, too.
Yes. And here's another bedroom right here that is a good-sized bedroom. It's on the end of the home. It juts out away from everything. As a matter of fact, you can look out the window right here and see the jut out of the home. And that's one of the other things. It does not make this feel like a mobile home at all. I mean, how often can you look out of it and see
part of the home?
Right, yeah. Because it's not just a rectangular shoebox.
Right. You know,
there's
that's
a lot
right.
to it. Beautiful home, though, overall.
Absolutely.
Another thing that I'm going to ask you guys about these windows real quick, I should have done it earlier, is they have white vinyl, or they have like this darker colored vinyl or aluminum. Do y'all like the white or the darker color? I think I like the white.
Really? I like the dark.
Well, me and you are just polar opposites.
We are. Walk-in closet.
A big walk-in closet. There again, this is your marriage wall. Look how thick that wall is right there.
Yeah.
That's insane.
Wow.
Isn't it?
It's over a foot.
And so we made it all the way down this long hallway. We went back and forth as we went in and out of each room.
Brandon, I just looked up ahead, and they've even got access to the attic area there.
You'll notice that it says it's not for storage. So here's something that a lot of people may not know about these homes. When they go to move them, if you look on the outside of the home, the pitch of the roof is so tall. If they were to take this thing down the highway, it'd be dragging the traffic lights.
Yeah.
So a lot of times these gables that are on the top of the roof are on hinges, and they lay down.
Oh, really?
So whenever they go to set your home up, they end up going through here as an access point to be able to lift the roof back up into place.
I didn't know that. And I noticed down through here, there's also vents in the ceiling, but we've got vents in the floor. We saw that earlier today.
Yeah.
What are they doing with that?
I don't know if it's heat in the floor, air in the ceiling, or vice versa. I'm really not sure. Again, like he said, we don't work here. We're not experts. We just like showing you all the homes and how beautiful they are. You know, if you get into the technical side.
I bet the people in the office could tell you all about that.
Oh, they absolutely could. So y'all be sure to call that number in the video description if you got questions that we haven't answered in this video.
Yeah.
So here we go. We saved the master bedroom for last. This is an absolutely beautiful bedroom that is separated off of that main hallway. So for those of you that like separation from, say, you and your kids, it's a big separation point between here and that last bedroom.
Be sure to drop a like on this video if you're getting value out of it.
Nice big bedroom.
Yeah, absolutely.
Plenty of size for a king-size bed. And we haven't been in that bathroom yet, so I'm curious to see.
No, and
like.
We got a big closet over there, too.
Yeah. Let's do the closet.
Right behind the door.
Let's do the closet.
They have a light in there?
Yeah, and it's deep. It goes farther back than I thought.
Oh, wow. Yeah. Oh, it does. Whoa. That's a big old closet.
It is. There again, if you don't like the wire racks, remember you can buy the wooden ones.
This is bigger than the stick-built home walk-in closet I had. It reminds me of it. It was set up very similar to the home that I used to live in. Huh, I really like that. And we're going in.
I couldn't wait, I had to go in.
You couldn't wait? He couldn't wait. Okay. All right, here we go. Master bath. All right, so we got a closet there. We'll come back and look at that. And then there is your two sinks, your mirrors, and your lighting above there. And your water or your potty closet is right here. Right here. And you got plenty of space. I'm going to look in the shower and... Did y'all see that in a reflection?
I hope not. It's been a long day.
It's been a long... You're relaxing already?
This is going to be...
Hold on. Let me see if they got the water hooked
up.
Turn
it on. It's getting deep.
It's getting real deep. It's
after
been
a long day of filming mobile homes. This would be where I would end my day. I'm just saying.
Yeah, absolutely.
Right. Nothing more manly than a bubble bath.
I'm telling you, I could see you in a bubble bath, man. Miranda would serve it up to you, I'm sure.
For the small price of $9.99, you can all see me in a bathtub. No,
he's kidding.
Am I? No,
that's funny. And we've got the rain head shower overhead and the wand. And of course, you've got your bench and you've got that shiplap look. And that feels like tile, Brandon. Is that tile?
Yep, 100% tile.
That's tile right there.
And for those of you curious, I used to lay tile once upon a time.
Did you really?
Yeah, I did. My dad had his own flooring company for several years. And my dad's done a lot. He's kind of a jack of all trades.
But I could barely build a birdhouse.
Let's well, I didn't inherit all of it, but oh yeah, I forgot. We do have a closet to look at.
Yeah.
There we go. Nice coat.
Towels. Yeah.
Why do you call them coat closets?
Well, you can put coats in there if you want to.
I guess so.
Call them what you like, I guess.
You did the potty closet.
I did.
All right. I guess we're to the end of it. We got to talk about pricing, right?
Yeah, we got to talk about pricing because everybody's going to get after us. And the pricing, again, is as of June 2023, subject to change. If you view this video a year or two from now, it's probably changed. Could have went up, could have went down, could have went all around. Yes. Depends on your customizations too. But we're going to go take a look at the price right now. Brandon, well, what's the damage on it?
Well, it's interesting.
It's better than I thought.
Yeah, it's really not bad if you consider it by the square foot. There again, this is 2,520 square feet. It's 47 by 80.
Yeah.
It's 4 bedrooms, 2.5 bath. This is called the Classy.
Or right? Class A.
Yeah. And it's kind of, yeah, Class A, yeah. So Deer Valley did build this. The price that you see is unfurnished. The one thing to keep in mind that this is deluxe appliances, thermal pane windows, upgraded insulation, OSB wrapped, OSB roof decking. So there again, you have a very upgraded home for that price point. The layout could be changed. There's always alternatives to the flooring and the paint colors. That's all stuff that you need to talk to the home place about. If you guys enjoyed this tour, and as we mentioned several times through the video, got value from it, please be sure that you're subscribed. And if you're not, at least go watch this video right up here in the corner, because I think you may like it, and that might be the video you sub from.
Let's go.